Hey, how you doing? Saturday again. Joe Walsh here. Welcome to the show. 88.5 FM. I'd like to remind you that 88.5 FM is funded by listener donations. The difference between us and regular radio stations is that we don't wear ties and we don't play what a computer tells us to. If you'd like to help support this station, think about becoming a member. For more information, you can go to 88.5fm.org. So, welcome to the show. I've got 2 hours of pretty good music. I went searching for some stuff on the internet, and I found it. I'll go through the set with you. We're going to open with Do It Again, Steely Dan. I can't think of a better song to open a show with. And then Who Do You Think You're Talking To by Dawes. Really good LA-based band I became aware of by listening to this station. And then Albert King, one of my mentors and Stevie Ray Vaughan's mentors. Albert King, Crosscut Saw. I had the honor of performing Amazing Grace on slide guitar at Albert's funeral in Memphis. Girls just want to have fun. Cindy Lauper, my wife, will confirm that. We're going to open with Do It Again, Steely Dan. Thanks for tuning in. 88.5 FM, here we go.
Just ask Joe.
This question is from Barb Fawcett from Worthington, Pennsylvania. Joe, I'm loving your show. My question is, when learning to play guitar, is it better to learn theory first or some chords, strum patterns, and songs? Thank you.
Hey, Barb, how you doing? Thanks for the question. Okay, to learn guitar, the first thing you do is tune the guitar down a half a note. Tune each string down a half a note. That will make the strings looser and your fingers won't hurt so bad. There are 6 basic chords, E, A, D, G, C, and F. Learn those and learn the minor form of each of those chords. Get it so when you hold your pick and you strum across the 6 strings, each note rings clearly and no string goes doink or thud. Okay? When you got each note of the chord ringing clearly, and you know those 6 chords and the minor forms, and that's not very hard, then get the first Beatles album. Every Beatles song is either those 6 chords or the minor form of those 6 chords. Every chord of every song you can play. You can play every Beatles song on the album. Start there and practice, practice, practice.
88.5 FM.
The last 4 songs you heard, Red Light by Johnny Lang. Johnny Lang's been around for a while. He got his first platinum album, I think he was 15 years old. And you know what I was doing when I was 15? Learning to tie my shoes. Johnny's really good guitar player. Who Can It Be Now? Men at Work. That's Colin Hay. He lives here now from down under. Speaking of that, Jimmy Barnes. Driving Wheels. Really good song. Jimmy was in the Australian band Cold Chisel. He's a national treasure in Australia. And then War on Drugs, Suffering, a Philadelphia-based band that Kurt Vile started. They make really good records.
Just ask Joe.
This question is from Lorelei in Cardinal Upton, Massachusetts. Joe, how did you meet your wife? Was it love at first sight?
Hey, Lorelai, how you doing? Thanks for the question. In 1982, I was in England at Ringo's house. We were working on a record, and Ringo's wife, Barbara Bach, has a little sister named Marjorie, and she stopped by briefly one afternoon, and it was love at first sight. We both had very separate lives, very different lives, and so I saw her maybe five or six times over the next 20 years, but every time we saw each other, when we hugged, we didn't want to let go. And I think we both knew. Anyway, in 2008, I married Marjorie. Now there's a love story. 88.5 FM. Joe Walsh here. So that was Into the Night by Carousel. Carousel is an LA-based duo, graduates of the Berklee School of Music in Boston. Really good music. They've got a YouTube video that I really, really enjoyed watching. Just two guys, and they sound like six. She's Gone from Hall & Oates. John's a good friend. And I was at, I played on Daryl's house on his show. He lives out in the middle of nowhere, but there's a great studio out there. Can't Find My Way Home, Blind Faith, Steve Winwood singing that. Heart of Glass, Blondie. I tried really hard not to like that song, but I gave up. I really thought it was dumb, and then I said, okay, I like it. And that's a good song. You can't not like that song. I'll be back and talk some more after a couple songs. 88.5 FM. The last four songs you heard, historical songs. Moving On Over by Hank Williams, recorded in 1947. That was Hank Williams' first major hit, and arguably, it is the first rock and roll song ever recorded. It predates Rock Around the Clock by Bill Haley, 1947. Crazy by Patsy Cline, generally regarded as one of the greatest female vocalists of all times. And that song, of course, written by Willie Nelson. More historical stuff. Why Do Fools Fall in Love by Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers, 1956. Frankie was, I think, 15 when he sang on that record. He died at 25. He burned a candle at both ends. His voice is regarded, I think, the king of rock and roll voices. And the queen, of course, would be Ronnie Spector from the Ronettes. I think Frankie Lyman and Ronnie Spector are the reigning king and queen of rock and roll voices. So that's hour one, and we'll attack hour two.
Just Ask Joe.
The next question is from Grace Jordan, who is not sure where she's from. Hi, how are you? I can't believe I'm talking to you. My question is, what is the one song that you absolutely love? Are you romantic? Will you and your son do Vets Aid in 2021? It is tradition for me to go see you and support our troops. I was really looking forward to seeing where you would pick to do it this year. I love you, Grace.
Hey, Grace, how you doing? Thanks for the question, and don't worry, I have no idea where I'm from either. My favorite piece of music is Adagio for Strings by an American composer named Samuel Barber. My favorite song is In My Life by the Beatles, a song John wrote. I can be very romantic. Let me give you a Vets Aid update. Impossible to do a live concert this year. My son and I, Christian, are planning a virtual event on December 12th of this year. And I guess vetsaid.org would be a good place to go to find more out about that. We do plan on doing a live concert in 2021, somewhere in the Midwest. And thanks for that question. 88.5 FM, Joe Walsh. Hour two, you just heard Thunderstruck AC/DC. That's a great way to start off an hour. Thinking about calling Brian Johnson, see if I can get a chat with him. He'd make a great guest. I'm just thinking out loud, but I'll get back to you about that. The only obstacle is I can't tell what the hell he's saying. But that's okay. Devil's Grin, Corey Marks, Canadian guy. He grew up listening to rock and roll, and his parents were pretty heavily into country music. So he's a hybrid, and I don't think it's country rock. I think it's more rock country, but he's making great records, and I think he has got a great future. I don't know what genre, but we'll see. Under My Thumb, Rolling Stones, that's a beauty. That's a beauty song. And Easy by Great Good Fine Okay, that's a New York duo. They're making great music. We'll be back after this.
Just Ask Joe.
The next question is from Sam Stebbins, and he's not sure where he's from either. Is your song Indian Summer actually about an unseasonably warm fall, or is it really about something else? Thanks, Sam.
Hey, Sam, how you doing? Thanks for the question. Indian Summer, let me paint a picture. I lived in Columbus, Ohio. It was 1959. I was about 11. It was the summer before I discovered girls. My whole world was about five blocks square, and everyone in my neighborhood, we were all buddies, we all rode bicycles, and we all had BB gun wars and snowball wars with the guys in the other neighborhoods. The summer seemed to last forever, and it was just a magical, naive innocence summer, and we felt immortal. And that's what I tried to capture in that song, Indian Summer. Thanks for the question. 88.5 FM, Joe Walsh here. Delirious by Prince. Demons by The National. The more I listen to them, the more I really like them. My new favorite band. Ceilings by The Local Natives. That's a Los Angeles group. They kind of got discovered at South by Southwest. They played a bunch of shows there, and word of mouth got out. I can't wait to hear some more stuff from them. Bell Bottom Blues, Derek and the Dominoes. And we're going to have my buddy Jeff Lynn showdown. Who's in the ELO? Jeff Lynn.
Just Ask Joe.
The next question is from Rudy in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Hiya, Joe. What were some of the challenges of running your own band that made joining the Eagles more appealing? Thanks, Rudy.
Hey, Rudy, how you doing? Thanks for the question. Good question. When I left the James Gang and began a solo career, gradually I realized that a lot of non-musical things came along with a solo career. And that was hiring and firing and deciding everything and a feeling of being alone. I had to write the music by myself. And it was just a different perspective, which I learned and enjoyed. And I think I had a very good solo career. That's when Life's Been Good and Rocky Mountain Way came out. But after a while, I kind of wanted to be part of. I was feeling creatively kind of stagnant and kind of overwhelmed by more and more non-musical decisions with more and more career success. So I felt like I wanted to be part of and be back in the band again. And right about then is when I got the phone call from Don and Glenn. Thanks.
Every time you go away.
88.5 FM, Joe Walsh here. Coming down to the end of hour two, I just want to say there's a lot of emails and very kind words coming into the station concerning my show. And much to my amazement, from all over the world. So to everybody who's listening, I would say, hey, how you doing? And however that is, me too. Okay, we'll go out with Annie Lennox and the Goo Goo Dolls. And that will complete the 13th week of the Joe Walsh Show. Who knew? See you next week. Keep your chins up and your heads down. Wash your hands, wear your mask, and God bless us all. See you next week.